everyone. It's Tanya from Shattered Bones. I keep hearing that I don't have TikTok or the app or anything, but I keep hearing that there are all of these supposed fakers, people faking that they have DID on TikTok and different YouTube channels. And as a person that has been diagnosed with that, and I am a system, a DID system, I want to give you my two cents on that, okay? And my two cents on the supposed fakers of DID who perhaps haven't been accurately diagnosed. For one, it does take a while. It took me almost 7 years to get my diagnosis from 2013 until 2021. And that was with a team of psychologists, psychiatrists, trauma therapists, ruling out different disorders and things like that to finally get my most accurate diagnosis. So it does take a while for somebody to get the accurate diagnosis of DID. However, for me personally, it hurts me more to have people like you saying that they're faking than it does for people to be faking this disorder, if that makes any sense at all. Because this disorder has a lot of stigma wrapped around it. We need as many people talking about it as possible so that more people understand what it is. And yes, we do create these different parts as a child. So I have non-human alters in my system as well. So that's not really as uncommon as people think. So I think that's another thing that people think, oh, they're just making these things up. I assure you, I'm not making any of this up. I'm 53 years old. There would be absolutely no reason for me to make this up. And of all my diagnoses, this is the one that's most stigmatized. I thought that being suicidal was the worst one and it was going to be the most stigmatized. But now it's not, because this is definitely the most stigmatized one. People automatically assume that we're dangerous because of Hollywood and the bogus way that they have portrayed this disorder. It's nothing like that. In fact, people like me have been traumatized to the point that we are most of the time, we are going to work really hard not to hurt anyone. We are more likely to be abused as an adult too. And that's what I've found to be true for me. So yeah, you know, I have an angry parts too, believe me. I only put up with so much crap, and then I'll fight back. Let's just put it that way. I'm not a doormat anymore. But as far as like being dangerous and things like that, no. The only one that I hurt is usually myself. And you know, one out of three people with this diagnosis die by suicide. So it's incredibly frightening. And it's not uncommon for us to have suicidal parts. And I have that. You know, parts of me that are suicidal. So it's terrifying to know that I can switch out into an actively suicidal part and have no conscious memory of that, and that person's driving my body. And you know, I'm working really hard. I am in a really good stable place. I'm trying to get back to work again. And so yeah, we can live beautiful, successful lives with this. But for anyone out there who is thinking, oh, this person's faking, that person's faking, you are the problem, not the person who you think is faking DID. You, the one who's accusing them of faking it, you are the problem. Neurotypical people think that they know what's going on in our minds, an atypical mind, but you don't. So take it for somebody who has DID, who is a mature adult. I am telling you, leave those children alone. If you don't believe them, slide on and go look at something else. Let them be. Okay? That's my two cents worth. Talk to you later. Love you all more. Bye.